Hey, welcome back everyone. My name is Prestige. Thank you so much for joining me on the channel. I got to give you guys a thank you for all of the continued support. I mean, literally, I've seen so much support on my new series that I've been uploading to the channel, like, for example, say, 5 Things You Didn't Know About Black Ops 3. A lot of you love that series. I love making it. It's so much fun. And it really does bring a new light to the game, really, because you learn things that you wouldn't normally know. And I know that a lot of you have been asking for another one, and I have one in the works right now, so prepare yourselves for that. But I wanted to just thank you guys so much for all the continued support once again. I really appreciate all the likes. I appreciate all the people that have been subscribing. It's going to be a great year for content right here on the channel. But before we get into the micro DLC talk, I would like to say there's going to be a double XP weekend coming tomorrow for Call of Duty Black Ops 3. It's going to cover multiplayer as well as zombies. So if you're trying to rank up there, begins tomorrow, probably around 12 Eastern time, 12 p.m. Eastern. So right in the morning, it's going to happen. It's going to turned on. So micro DLC has been a controversial subject for Call of Duty for the past few years. You know, it originally started with camouflages that we were able to get with Call of Duty Black Ops 2. Then eventually it kind of rolled into something completely different, from voice packs down to character customization, down to just supply drops in general. And I think that a lot of people are worried with what Treyarch's going to do with their microtransactions, but I'm here to bring you guys a little bit of hope. I'm here to bring you some little comforting words. I wouldn't really worry too much about what Treyarch's gonna do with micro DLC, because I can already tell you some of the things they're gonna do. First thing I can expect to see, they're gonna do, of course, the personalization packs, meaning you're gonna get camouflage, you're gonna get reticles, you're gonna get your calling cards, stuff that we've seen in the past, and I think that that's fine. If I could spend $1.99 and get guaranteed a camouflage, I would be A-okay. The thing that I would not like, and this is something that Advanced Warfare did last year, and if they do this, I'm gonna be very upset, is if they bring the ability to buy crypto keys and then they say, yeah, we just released some new camouflage, but hey, it's only available in the black market. That would piss me off, and I think it's going to make a lot of other people mad if they decide to do that. But like I said before, in Treyarch we trust. I'm going to hope for the best, and I'm going to hope that you can buy camouflages outright instead of buying crypto keys. And if crypto keys are purchasable, it really wouldn't be as bad as it was in Advanced Warfare. Remember, Advanced Warfare had variants that you were able to obtain. Some of those variants did give you a competitive edge, but a lot of the time there really wasn't anything extra about them. As to where in Black Ops 3, you're going to be able to earn just simply aesthetic looking things. Things to change the way your weapon looks, you know, emotes for your character to make them do different taunts and gestures, of course, different camouflages. But once again, that camouflage thing that I just talked about before, if that happens, I'm going to be pretty upset where they put reticles and stuff in the supply drops. As for everything else, I think that we will see new specialist characters coming as DLC. I think that it would be silly to end on 9. I don't think that they would be included in the season pass, because the season pass only clarifies that there's going to be 4 DLC packs with zombies and whatnot. I don't think that they will add anything there. If they do, it's going to be a DLC weapon, which I can also see them adding DLC weapons into this game. If they don't, then once again, they're probably going to focus everything on those specialist characters. And if specialist characters do decide to come in as micro DLC for people to purchase for $1.99, $5.99, whatever it's going to be, I can already see all of the people complaining about so-and-so is overpowered, or so-and-so doesn't do enough damage for the amount of money that I paid, or whatever it is. That's the only problem that I see with micro DLC coming in, you know, with specialist characters. And that's the only reason I can think of, oh, maybe they will just add specialist characters for free, since it's kind of an integral part to the game. I don't know what to expect. It's really, it's on the fine line there, right? It's a very eerie thing. It's shady. It's not really something that is upfront and just in your face. It's something that you really have to think about. Is this something that's going to be super overpowered? Is this something that's going to be balanced? Is this something that's going to be worth purchasing for another thing? I really hope that these crypto keys don't turn out to be similar to what supply drops were, where exclusive gear is only obtainable in the supply drops. So that really kind of does make me, among other people, want to buy those crypto keys in order to get that gear. I absolutely loved Advanced Warfare for what it was, but the only problem is they added the DLC weapons to the supply drops, and that caused a lot of content creators, including myself, to try to buy as many supply drops as you can in order to get those new weapons. Now, I am not proud to say this, but I've bought probably over 200 supply drops when the Cell 3 cauterizer came out for Advanced Warfare, and I never seen it. I never seen it at all. And then all of a sudden, boom, out of a regular drop, I got it. Like, that doesn't make any sense to me. If I'm willing to drop hundreds of dollars on supply drops, I'm really hoping to get something interesting. That wasn't even including legendary stuff. I didn't even get legendary stuff. So that's the problem for me. I don't want to have another Advanced Warfare supply drops. I like how supply drops are right now. And I think if they add the ability to purchase the keys, that's when we're going to start seeing exclusive items put into those supply drops, but I don't think that that's going to happen because, like I said before in the beginning of this video, in Treyarch we trust. I really hope that they don't, but if they do, I can wholeheartedly say it's an Activision decision. But you know what? If it happens, it happens, and that's a sad thing, and our community will just be ripperoni. I mean, it's literally, people are going to be so vocal about the issue. And that's what we need when it comes to micro DLC. There's been a lot of companies that have done a lot of shady things with micro DLC, but I don't think Treyarch is going to be one of those companies. And we'll see what happens. I'm sure our DLC season will start rolling out with DLC 1 or whatever. See more maps and we'll see more camouflages, like I said before. But hopefully they don't add them to supply drops. And I think that they will add stuff to supply drops, but for free. And that would be great. But I don't know, guys. Let me know what you think down below in the comments section. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to click that like button down below. And do not forget to subscribe for more awesome videos each and every day. Also, if they were to add DLC to the supply drops, that wouldn't really make any sense on a business standpoint because you can earn the crypto keys in-game. So technically, you would be giving away DLC for free for people that are loyal and play the game, which would sound great in a perfect world, but as a business decision, it doesn't sound right and it wouldn't work. So I hope that they don't do that once again, and I don't think that they will, but I just needed to talk about it in this video because I'm not really worried about what happens. I'm worried about what happens with the supply drops more than anything.